best team in qualifying so far. I don't know if they were maybe undefeated. Yeah, but they're looking strong, man. And from what I understand as well, going into things, I don't think they've really got injuries now. I know Barella was injured for a while, but I think he's back for Inter and stuff. So yeah, I think they're looking good, and I think that they will win the group. Beyond that, I think that Turkey are the second best team. I do think that Turkey, you know, they've got a lot of good players now. Soyuncu, obviously, the Yilmaz has just won the league at Lille and won their player of the season. I know he's 35, but he's in the form of his life. Yeah, you know, they've got good players. Kalinoglu, AC Milan, so, yeah, good team. I think that they'll finish second. Again, I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't find it a major shock if Turkey actually ended up topping the group. But yeah, I think they're the best two teams in the group. I think then Wales and Switzerland, for me, are probably about on par. And I think it was 2016 when Wales got to the semis. I don't think that they're kind of at that level anymore. Obviously, it's unhelpful what's happened with them with Ryan Giggs. They're basically, I think they've just had like a standing manager now for about 6 months, so not helpful leading into a major tournament at all. Switzerland as well, not as good as they probably were 4 years ago, I wouldn't say. So very much a toss-up. If it would finish third there, I'm going to go for Wales though, I think. So yeah, Italy first, Turkey second, Wales third, Switzerland out is what I would say. Group B, Denmark, Finland, Belgium and Russia. I think Belgium definitely are the strongest team here, out of the ones listed there. So they'll finish first. I would then say that Denmark would probably be my second strongest team. I know Russia did well for their home World Cup in 2018. I don't think they're not as good as then, and also they're not at home anymore and they're not riding that sort of crest of the wave. I do think they will probably finish third though, Russia, with Finland dropping out. Great team spirit for Finland, obviously they've got Teemu Pukki, but yeah, not one of the weakest teams in this, I would suspect. Group C, Holland, Ukraine, Austria and North Macedonia. Obviously Holland have got great players on paper, and you know, they had quite a good obviously they had some lean times after the 2014 World Cup when they finished third, and then I think it was Koeman that came in and they started to look like they were doing well again. Obviously the last Nations League tournament, they beat England, didn't they, in the semi-final of that, and they were looking good, man. And they've got, you know, like Depay just on fire, Wijnaldum on fire, Van Dijk, so that they were sort of like the spine of the team, whereas obviously Van Dijk's out of this tournament now, and I think since Koeman went to Barca, from what I understand anyway, they've not really been doing as well. So yeah, it's quite a tight group, this. I think obviously on paper Holland have got amazing players, but I wouldn't be surprised to see Austria topping this group. I am still going to go for Holland topping it, but again, I wouldn't be surprised if something goes awry there. I fancy Austria to finish second in this group. Obviously they've got Alaba and some other strong players. Yeah, again, I wouldn't be surprised if Ukraine finished second, though, or won the group, or if Austria won the group. It's a bit of a toss-up, this one. I am going to go Holland first, though, Austria second, Ukraine third, North Macedonia out. I think North Macedonia are the weakest team in the tournament. You know, when one of your most well-known players is Leeds' left-back, Alioski, it probably won't be at Leeds next year, or if he will, he'll be a backup left back. can't see that happening for them. Group D, England, Croatia, Scotland and Czech Republic. Now, I'm guessing many of you will already know this, that if England finish first in the group, the next round is going to be fucking solid. No matter... if they top the group, it's going to be solid, whoever they play. Because you'll be playing either Portugal, France or Germany. The rewards of winning the group are not as good as if they finish second. If they finish second, they're probably likely to face Poland or Sweden. So, but then I think they would end up playing France in the quarters. So, you know, it swings around about. But yeah, I digress. Croatia are the tough team in this group. Of course, they knocked us out at the World Cup. I don't think Croatia are as good a team as they were in the World Cup, though. Modric is older, for example. Although he's, you know, he's been playing well as of late. Yeah, I just don't think they're quite where they were in the World Cup. And for England, I would have said England are now stronger. If Harry Maguire's fit. If England don't have Harry Maguire fit for this tournament, and I'm not saying this just because I'm a Man United fan, big, big problems, huge problems, I would say. yeah, enormous problems. I remember Gary Neville saying a few weeks ago that it was a bigger deal for England if Harry Maguire gets injured than Harry Kane does. Carragher ripped him to shreds for it. I agree. You've got people that can come in and do a job up front for England. England are very good in an attacking sense anyway, with players in the wide berths and attacking midfielders who can create things for the likes of a Calvert-Lewin, for example. Any of the options to replace Harry Maguire worry me dramatically. If you think John Stones has had his resurgence season with Ruben Dias. Now, in the friendlies recently, he made that absolute clangor in the friendly. I'm still not convinced that John Stones is international level. I think he can look good when playing alongside a company or a Ruben Dias. He has done much better, and I'm not shitting on him. But John Stones with Tyrone Mings, for example, which is probably who he would be playing with. Just pack your bags, we're gone. Nothing good's going to come of that. So yeah, it's very dependent on Harry Maguire for me. But I think he will be fit. I do. I think he's running already. You know, he's got a good 2 to 3 weeks now, hasn't he? So it was only a week ago he did it, and he's already running. So I think he'll be all right. I'm going to go for England to finish top of the group. But I wouldn't be surprised if we managed to just scrape by getting second with Croatia winning. I think Scotland could be a problem for us. I really could see that happening. But I'm going to go England first, Croatia second, Scotland third, with the Czechs out. Scotland have done well, you know, as of late. They've had, obviously, a hugely fallow period. And the team looks quite good now, you know. Scott McTominay, Robertson, Tierney, McGinn, Shea Adams coming in for them. A really good positive that they've got, so the spine of that team is looking pretty decent, I'd say. Next group then, group E, Spain, Sweden, Poland, Slovakia. So, Spain have obviously announced that Ramos isn't going. I can see that Piqué is not in the squad either, I believe. Yeah, that's going to be an interesting one. I think, by all accounts, their starting centre-backs will be Pau Torres, who I know that Man United are after and other teams are supposed to be after. Looks good, young. And Eric Garcia, who's not played a lot of football for City this year. Again, probably going to Barca in summer on a free and highly rated, but hasn't really played. They do have problems up front as well. Gerard Moreno's obviously scored 30 goals for Villarreal this year, and I think he's probably going to start, by all accounts, over Morata. So he could unlock that door for them. But as we know, Spain have just not been the team that they were maybe 10 years ago for quite some time now. I still think they'll win the group, though. I do. I fancy them to do it. I wouldn't be surprised, though, if Poland won the group. I wouldn't be surprised at all. Lewandowski is in the form of his life. He's having a just, I mean, it just doesn't age, does it? Unbelievable. And I think him alone would be enough to fire them to second. I could see him winning the golden boot for the tournament, definitely. Sweden without Ibra is a big blow for them. I do, however, think they'll finish third because Slovakia, again, one of the weaker teams in this. Group F, Hungary, Portugal, France, Germany. How has that happened? In a six-group tournament where you've got the likes of North Macedonia, Slovakia, even Finland, Czech Republic, how have Portugal, France and Germany been put in the same group? It just beggars belief, doesn't it? How, what's happened there with the seedings and stuff? I mean, Portugal won the last Euros, France won the last World Cup, and Germany won the World Cup in 2014. You know, again, it's done on qualifying form. I guess there's a lot of merit to that. I suppose that is a meritocracy, I guess, but I don't know. Hungary should comfortably finish bottom there. I fancy France to finish first. I fancy Portugal to finish second, and I fancy Germany to finish third. You know, those three, though, swap any of those about. They could finish in any order, no doubt about it. I just think, obviously, France won the last World Cup. I think they are favourites for this tournament. France's third team would probably do well in this tournament. France's second team would have a great shout of getting to the semis or a final. They are scary how much depth they've got. Benzema coming back in. You know, whatever you might think of that ethically, him coming back in, but obviously that's a bonus for them footballing wise. Scary. Portugal, cracking team now. You know, Ruben Dias, Premier League Player of the Year. Fernandes, was he runner up for Player of the Year? Probably was, wasn't he? You'd think. Phenomenal team. Ronaldo is fit. And Germany have just been declining and declining and declining. Centre back, I think, is a real problem for them, which is, I'm guessing, why they've brought Hummels back in. I think Hummels has played well this season by all accounts at Dortmund, but they've been a leaky defence, Dortmund. I don't know. That's the way I'm thinking it will go, but it could go anyway. So then you've got to pick the way it works, because there's only six groups. You've got to pick your fourth highest points totals for the third place teams. So I think that Scotland could do all right, you know, in the group with Croatia and England. I could see them nicking points there, and I could see them, having said that, I could see them probably still losing to the Czech Republic. Interesting. Germany could pick up points there. I'm going to say Germany. I think they'll certainly beat Hungary. Ukraine in their group, I think, could definitely take points off Holland and Austria, so I'd put them through. Sweden with Spain and Poland, I'm not sure about them. Russia with Belgium, Denmark and Finland, I could definitely see Russia picking points up there, so I'm going to put them through. And then Wales with Switzerland, Turkey and Italy, I could see Wales picking up points. So I'm going to say that Scotland and Sweden would go out. So this gives us the following fixtures. We'd have Italy versus Austria. Now, I do see Italy winning that. Turkey versus Denmark, that's a really good tie. I think that Turkey are the slightly stronger team there, so I could see Turkey having a bit of a run in this tournament, actually, like they did in the 2002 World Cup. So I would, and I think Yilmaz is gonna get some goals in this tournament. That's a prediction. I'm gonna put them through. Belgium versus Wales, was that? Did they face each other in the last Euros? And I feel like, did Belgium knock them out? I could be dreaming that, but I fancy, obviously, Belgium for that. Holland versus Germany, that's a really good tie, isn't it? Cracking tie, that. I mean, you know, just, again, for me, just toss a coin on that one. I think that's a really 50, currently right now, I think that's a really 50-50 game. I'm going to say that I fancy Holland for it, actually. goal scorer is going to be at a premium. France, Ukraine, I definitely fancy France. Spain, Russia, I think Spain have got an easy one there. I'm going to go for Spain. England, Portugal. Wow. Wow. Interesting. A lot of this is going to depend on what Southgate does. I think this is probably a good time for me to mention. For me, I'm banking on Maguire being fit. So I'm saying that everyone that has got an injury right now is going to be fit. So let's work on that premise. Maguire, Henderson. Even if Henderson's fit, Henderson hasn't played since February. For me, Henderson cannot be starting for England. He needs to go as a glorified cheerleader. And I'm not saying that in a disrespectful manner. When you've got 26 players, you can afford to take somebody like that as a cheerleader. I mean, Spain have chosen to just take 24 players. They haven't even filled their full 26 because they recognise that you're going to have players that will not play. So I'd still take him. I wouldn't start him, though. And I'd have a midfield three of Declan Rice, Jude Bellingham, who actually does a hell of a lot of good defensive work. I think that was noticeable in the Champions League. Really excellent sort of box-to-box midfielder who, you know, gets stuck in. So he can help Rice and then Mason Mount. So I think that's a really, really balanced, incredible, in fact, the most balanced England midfield that I can remember really in a long, long time. Declan Rice, Jude Bellingham, box-to-box and energy, and Mason Mount, still who works hard and presses like nobody's business, but with a lot of license to get forward and create. I like the sound of that. You know, I also think now when you think about the likes of the possibilities of Foden, Grealish, Rashford, Sterling in with Kane, I wouldn't play Sterling and Rashford. I think Foden has to start. I think there's question marks on Grealish with the fitness. I'm not sure whether I would play Foden and Grealish with Kane because of pace. And I think that you need somebody to be able to run beyond. Say if you had Kane and Foden. And I know that Foden is quick, but he's not blistering pace. I think you want somebody who could just fucking peg it. Absolutely peg the way that Son does. And I think that would probably on merit have to be Sterling. And I really, really like the sound of Foden, Kane and Sterling. With that midfield three, and if Maguire and Stones are fit, you know, I'm going to go for England. I'm going to back England to beat Portugal. I am, you know, I'm going to do it. Let's go for it. Three Lions and all that. So the quarterfinals then would give us Poland versus France, and I think that would be the end of Poland's run. I could see Poland being knocked out in the quarters, and Lewandowski still finishing as top scorer. See him scoring against France still, you know, bagging a ton of goals up to that point. You know, top scorer, Poland, see you later. Belgium versus Italy is an amazing quarter final. I don't rate Roberto Martinez as a manager. I really, really do not. I think he is part of the reason why Belgium have kind of come up short a little bit in major tournaments when they've got a very blessed squad. I don't think he's that good a manager. I think if Spurs get Pochettino back rather than Martinez, that's a better move for them. So I'm going to go for Italy to make a deep run here. Holland versus Turkey is a cracking game, and you know what? I'm just going to go for it, mate. I can see Turkey getting to the semi-finals. Spain versus England. Let's Billy Big Balls it. And I'm going to go for... I think Portugal's a tougher game than Spain. I do. So I'm going to go for England to beat Spain. We beat them, obviously, and I think in Bilbao in the Nations League a couple of years ago. I think when we were like 3-0 up at half time, and Kane Sterling and Rashford just tore him a new arsehole. It was magical. So yeah, let's go for that. France versus Italy. So this is where I see Italy bowing out after a very successful tournament, and France making to the final. Turkey versus England. Now it would be very England-esque to beat Croatia and top the group, and then beat Portugal, and then beat Spain, and only to lose to Turkey. However, I think they'll win. And then you'd have a France versus England final, and we'd say, "Wow, what a tournament!" And France had spank us 3-0 in the final. So yeah. interestingly, it lets me know here, most predicted to win by people that have done this interactive bracket so far. So 22% of people that have done it have voted with me and said that France will win, and 15% have then voted for England. So a France-England final seems to be the popular vote. That was this video, guys. Let me know what you think in the comments. Am I talking absolute pants? Do I swear too much in these videos? Maybe I do. Apologies for that.